Hi everyone, today I'm taking my HB Cheap and Run Ice deck out for a little ride. I've played Cheap and Run Ice for both NBN and Wayland, trying to fast advance, but I have very limited success with that. Today I'm trying it with NBN, hopefully this will work, and if it does, I might use it as my staple deck from now on. The biggest drawback of HB is that there's absolutely no way to punish the runner for tagging. And if I try to include tech punishment, it will slow my deck down a lot, and I'll have to pay a lot of influence for it, so I gave up the idea. So now, the match has started. I'm fighting against Reyna Roja. She makes some very reckless runs, and forced me to rest ice over my HQ. My second turn, I get the remote up and ready to score a efficiency committee. Getting an early efficiency committee score is extremely huge, especially when you start with a shipment from Sensen in your hand. It enables your fast advance to begin. It is basically no different from scoring an Astro script in NBN. So I definitely want that score, and I get that score, however, at a cost. I misplayed by raising the Eli on hit on R&D, which left me with insufficient credits to defend my remote. So after raising my Chimera, I had one credit left. The only way I was going to score the efficient C committee was to use my shipment from Sensen. So I did that. That's the other good thing about shipment from Sensen. It allows you to score even though you only have one credit in your credit pool. Thankfully for that. Yes. The next turn, I immediately used one efficiency committee token because I needed to firstly get my credit pool back up into the green and to take advantage of my HP ability. So I felt that that was a justified use of the efficiency committee. Then I also iced archives because I was preparing for a power shutdown. And seeing that he has a data sucker, I don't want him to get any free tokens. He then runs through my Eli, losing clicks for that. My deck has a mix of both cheap and run ice and taxing ice, the likes of Eli and Viper. I like to have these ice go on top of R&D and HQ to drastically slow the runner down. Yes, I noticed that he played Joshua B the last turn. That has to go. That definitely has to go. So, yeah. It's a huge mistake not to trash Joshua B, and even though it costs me more to trash it than it costs for him to play it, it is absolutely necessary to trash him. Next turn, he continues spamming these tag me resources. Makes me really wish that I have some form of tag punishment, but no, I don't. So I have to trash his activist support, which would give me one bad pup at the end of my turn if I didn't trash it, as well as a second Joshua B. Meanwhile, he continues building up with a clone chip ready to recurse a parasite at any moment. He forces also the rest of my Eli over HQ, which is fine. And amazingly, I had 4 agendas in my hand, or 5 cards, and he hits the power shutdown. That was very, very close for me. Yes, I draw the successful demo, which wasn't very useful, unfortunately. And I trash one of my agendas into archives, hoping that he wouldn't run there. I was definitely getting agenda flooded. And I didn't have any way to pump them out into the remote, unfortunately. He account siphons me. I'm down to 0 credits, unfortunately. But I draw into a shipment from Sensen, which means I can score as long as I have a single credit in my credit pool. And what better agenda to score than accelerated beta test to get me more ice, rest ice at that. So yes, I was positioning myself to score that. However, more importantly, I needed to discard the same old thing on the table, because if I didn't do that, he would account siphon me again next turn. So yeah, there was no point in gaining credits when he would just suck them away with account siphon. So I had to trash his same old thing. I was definitely slowing down. He then tried to destroy my Eli. However, he was one data sucker token short. This is why it's so important to protect archives. I mean, all 3 central servers, actually, against anyone who plays data sucker. And my deck is able to do that with a suite of very many cheap ice. Even Ela and Viper only cost 3 to res. I definitely felt a pinch from Reyna Roja's ability, but, well, that's the cost that you have to pay. I joined to the Sensen. I was very happy to see that. I knew that his economy wasn't very good. He was trying to keep me poor, but at the same time, he's not very rich himself. So, trashing my Sensen is a big loss to him. So, that has to go into the reward. And I gained a couple of credits while I'm at it. He immediately runs the server. He knows that that's a Chimera. I know that. I'm not going to res it. I'll let you trash it if you want. You'll lose a lot of tempo. And sure enough, he doesn't. He then runs Archives for the Data Sucker token. I let him through. That could have been a mistake, but I think giving up the two agenda points and the Eli in front of my HQ was probably the better choice. I needed to leave the ice in front of there because I was about to accelerate third beta test. So I need to make sure that he doesn't get in for free the next turn. So I score and I definitely use the ability. Triggering ABT is very controversial. Personally, I think that it should always be triggered as long as the runner is not a match point. Especially since I don't run any 3-pointer ice, I'm perfectly comfortable with letting the runner score one agenda or even two if I get unlucky. The thing is, the tempo advantage you gain from installing a rare piece of ice for free at no cost of clicks or credits is way too huge to give up. Especially in a rush deck like mine. Meanwhile, I continue to solidify HQ. I know that the account siphon will return anytime, any moment, and I cannot afford to let him have free reign on my credit pool. I know I have enough agendas to win the game in my hand alone. So I'm just waiting for the moment where I can accumulate enough credits or shipments from Sensens to either Sensen City Grid or shipments from Sensens to score them both. I draw into more ice. After some thinking, I decided to ice up Archives even more. I need to make sure that every time he wants to gain Data Sucker tokens, he has to pay a lot. Actually, right now, his best play would probably be to lock down R&D, because with two Data Suckers, he can easily make one run on R&D every turn for 2 credits. But he doesn't, so I continue boosting my economy. I find that my economy is very stagnant, even though I have quite a few economy operations, because raising ice costs so much. It's quite painful playing against Reyna Roja. But, well, that's the price I have to pay. So, he jumps his knight there. I mean, I find it weird that he's attacking HQ instead of R&D, but, well, it was a signal that he had an account siphon in hand. So both of his knights were on HQ. I simply needed one action to install over both pieces of ice, and suddenly both his knights were trash. What he should have done was to install the knight on his side of the table, but not jump the knight. He should jump the knight the next turn and play the account siphon from there. But well, he doesn't care. He just plays the account siphon straight up. I show him the Viper. He clone chips the parasite away. And Sensen. Now, what you gonna do? I have no credits left. Hit me. No, he doesn't. He hits my hand instead and scores the Vitruvius. Well, very well. I gain some credits instead. Here I'm actually made an illegal play, if you notice, because Octagon didn't record my clicks, or rather it recorded my clicks too fast. I clicked too fast for Octagon, and so I gained an extra click in addition to the single efficiency committee. So that was my bet there. I should not have been able to trigger the hedge fund. That didn't make a difference in the end, because I would have still been able to score the Vitruvius. He tries to make a final desperation run. Just keep in mind that had I not made the illegal play just now, I would be on 4 credits less because I wouldn't have been able to play the hedge fund. I'll be on 2 credits. Yes. Here I had to make a choice, either to protect archives or R&D, because he played a data leak reversal. I could have tried to DLR, but that would have been too much of a tempo hit for me. So between R&D and archives, I took a gamble. I gambled that there were no agendas on the top of R&D, and indeed there weren't, so I scored Director Haas's pet project for the win. Okay, so the extra hedge fund did make the difference in the end. I'm sorry for that. But otherwise, I see that this deck is pretty decent. I'll definitely need to improve my play on it. But otherwise, I think this is a perfectly viable deck. The strength of playing HB as opposed to other factions is that you have easily the best taxing ice in the entire game across all four factions. Ela and Viper are way too powerful. This frees up a lot of influence for you to splash other cards that help in your fast advance, such as the both Sand Sands, Shipment and City Grid. Those are very important components to this fast advance deck. Thanks for watching. I hope to practice this with this deck more often. You'll see more videos of it in the future.